civilization thinks, and our game as the Swahili. Now, as you'll recall, in the last game, we were having some issues with the Netherlands exerting loyalty on Kalemain. Currently, it's going to rebel in 6 turns, but we also need Hercules to finish building some districts for us. So, we'll go ahead and send Herc up to another city. The question is, which one? It would certainly be smart to save his charges for the harbors that we want to get online as soon as possible. Guess another option would have been to make our government plaza in this city and help fend off the loyalty. But that's alright. So maybe what we actually do is we queue up this harbor. And then we, Hercules is going to be around for 24 turns. Shipbuilding finishes in 7, maybe less if we boost it. So, we could use Hercules' charges. Yeah, I think that's a good idea. Also, it occurred to me that we should get this coffee online, yeah. Yeah, I think that's what the plan was. That I didn't even talk about what the Oracle did. So, let's go to the Civilopedia. Recalling heroes costs 15% less faith, and patronage of great people costs 25% less faith. Districts in this city provide +2 great person points of their type. For example, great writer points from the Theater Square district must be built on hills. So that is the benefit that we are gaining from the Oracle. Kilwa Kiswani is currently working on Apadana, which would give us 2 envoys whenever a wonder is built, including Apadana. So, not a huge, not an incredibly game-changing benefit for us, but, we want wonders, right? That's our reason for being, so. So Hercules will use his charges. He can build 2 more districts. No, Hercules can just fortify. He will use his 2 remaining districts on the harbor in Kalemain and the harbor in Melindi. And we may very well be going to war with the Netherlands. I don't like this barbarian up there. We're going to send the Sardine to go attack it. Outside. I hope things are going well for you, by the way. We need more builders as well. We're having some builder issues. Well, not builder issues per se, but we're having builder shortages. We have tiles that I want to improve. We also need to make some decisions about where our corporations are going. And I think it's clear that Kilwa Kiswani is going to have a coffee corporation. Because we are playing with that game mode, right? I think we are. I usually play with monopolies and corporations, that game mode. Discovered the hero Sinbad, claimed by by Wilhelmina. Sinbad is a great, great hero. Okay, yeah, this is why you should always be suspicious of the auto-tasking of, of units, because they do foolish things like that. I wanted to attack this barbarian galley, but the autotasking just decided to do its own thing. Okay. Kelamine will rebel any turn now, and that's totally fine. We'll just take it right back. But anyway, only, each city can only have one corporation, and so it's smart to strategize, and if you have a city that can choose from multiple corporations in its territory, and then another city that can only do one of those, we're just passing by, then you can heal there, that's fine. Smart thing to do is, get both corporations by, jiggering them in that way, where you get the one in the city that just has two of the same. I know I'm just kind of babbling a little bit. I felt settled that a lot clearer. Just fortify. Rotterdam is expanded to the areas that I was gonna send my guy to block at, but that's fine. You just go ahead and fortify anyways, or actually go there. We have an envoy. Let me check my government to see if we have, we have diplomatic league plugged in, so we get good value by sending an envoy to Monaco. We do have quite a bit of gold income every turn, so we could be using that to maybe buy another builder. I think buying a builder wouldn't be, this is why it didn't pop up. We haven't unlocked currency yet, so I think we will do this. We will buy a builder, chop out Apadana, and then put an industry or corporation. I can never remember what they're called, which stage is which. I think it's an industry, and then a corporation, and then a monopoly. Or no, monopoly isn't even an improvement. It's just a condition of having a lot of a resource. I know that these are all like obvious terms in common parlance, but they all have specific game meanings. Okay, I think I'm okay keeping all of these plugged in, except for maybe caravanseries. We might be able to put in a better one. Or maybe not. Maybe not really. Ilkham for some more builders, perhaps. I'll take inspiration to help get a few more great scientist points. This builder step there. Okay, so Kelamine flipped. We're gonna hit the city a bunch with our little weak units, and then Hercules will capture it. And yes, we will be keeping the city. Thank you. Us a granary and get us a harbor down, because Hercules will finish that next turn. We'll go games and recreation. So, we should put see why. Well, I'll just tell you why. Doubles the adjacency bonus from commercial hubs and harbors in this city. And we already have a plus 5 harbor, and that's only going to improve as we put additional districts next to it. And I'm thinking we'll put a commercial hub in here, because that'll get pretty good adjacency as well. By the way, with my more sensitive mic, you might be able to hear just a few seconds ago, my dog let out a big sigh. You might have been able to hear that, I don't know. But then, oh, well, now he's actually coming straight up to the mic. I guess he heard me talking about him, and he stood up and came up to my chair. He wants some attention. Go back to sleep, buddy. We will promote this galley with Emblon for a little more strength in our naval battles. And then we're going to go for currency. We will chop the woods here. Fortify. Ships down here. It's not a good sign when you see Dutch boats on the horizon. And now that we have shipbuilding, we can have Hercules use his special ability on our harbors. So that's nice. We'll fortify you in here. I don't know if there's inherently a loyalty bonus that comes from having a garrison unit in a city. I know that there's a policy card that gives a loyalty bonus for that, but I don't know if that's inherent as well, if there's a sort of inherent bonus there. Okay. I think we will chop these deer as well. We'll put a district. And then we're going to teleport our Hercules over to Melindi to finish the harbor there. We'll check our quick deals. The quick deals mod is a lifesaver, by the way. Now we can sell things to the Netherlands and to Poland. And I'd rather sell strategics to the Netherlands. But they're not particularly interested in our strategics. So we'll sell the horses to the Netherlands, and that's really not such a big deal. Because, you know, I'm not too concerned about horse units rolling up on me. So, this builder is going to get us the Netherlands only just got their Pantheon. Pretty late to the party there. My ancestor Darius and we got Apadana. My ancestor Darius made this Apadana, but it was burnt down by the grace of Ahura Mazda, Ahura Mazda, Anahita, and Mithra. I reconstructed this Apadana. Artaxerxes II. Alright, builder, step over there. We'll heal up this galley. Hercules, build the harbor district. And now, start going for these city-states, but we'll hold on to those envoys for now, I think. that's fine, but maybe we can actually put some effort into preventing. Yeah, we could put in limitane to get an extra bit of loyalty in the city. Where do we check our loyalty reports? Loyalty, okay. Loyalty per turn is falling by 8 a turn, so the plus 2 loyalty will, you know, staunch the bleeding a little bit, but not too much. Okay, the Netherlands just clearly has a little army rolling around, so I do need to turn my attention to the defense of my homeland, lest I be caught unprepared. You stand before Basil, autocrat and emperor of the Romans, scourge of my foes. Behold Rome. Would you like to visit our city? Yes. Well, nice to meet you, Basil. Okay. We now have an industry on this coffee, which gives us a pretty productive tile, and gives us plus 20% culture in this city. So that tells me that we should get a theater squared up at some point to maximize on that gain. Also, we should get Petra, because if we don't start building it soon, we're going to miss it. Although, here's the thing, there's no point really in beelining it, because this city's going to keep flipping loyalty-wise. So instead, we'll stop by for the wheel, so that we can get a little bit of extra production in our cities, thanks to water wheels. Okay. So I do have this levied army here, which, you know, does give me a bit of defense, but I think what we probably need to do, oh, I forgot to send him a delegation. He probably wouldn't have taken it anyways. The game seems to have a, okay, it's silly that I have to move my troops from the border when they're just standing there and have been for many, many turns. Okay. Hercules can camp out here for a minute. This galley can go exploring. We have a lot of gold. A lot of gold. What to do with that gold? We could certainly buy another builder. You know, that's not a bad choice by any means. Because that would allow us to get a corporation or an industry on this opal here. And I do not mind that idea. So what I'm thinking is this. We have coffee there. This city is olives. Of course, we have to get another copy of olives before we could actually do that, because it requires two copies of a resource to form an industry. And then this city will be whales. And then this city will be opal. So, yeah, I like that. Let's get, or we could buy something else. No, let's just stick with the builder. Let's get these industries online. The annoying thing in this particular situation is that we're going to have to improve the opal with one builder charge, and then put an industry down with our second builder charge, because we don't really have enough opal to... You're gonna take my iron for open borders. What if I give you a little more and ask for a bit more as well. If I give you some coffee. 11 turns, or 11 gold, 30 turns, 50 gold now. It's a good deal. I'll take it.
Sometimes.
Joker goes there to get the opal rolling. I feel like we need to research masonry so that we can put some walls in our city. I'm starting to have a bit of fear at how our friend is, our Dutch friends are looking at us. The mausoleum at Halicarnassus could go here. That's a wonder that we certainly don't want to miss out on. It's a really, really great wonder. It lets all great engineers get an additional charge. And then it also gives some extra yield to the coastal waters of that city. Old Faithful, we found a natural wonder. It spouted at regular intervals 9 times during our stay, the columns of boiling water being thrown from 90 to 125 feet at each discharge, which lasted from 15 to 20 minutes. We gave it the name of Old Faithful. Nathaniel P. Langford. Where is that? Katna. Oh, hey, look at that. Basil's friendly with us, so we'll go ahead and declare friendship. Oh, we can't. It's not our turn right now. Okay, we have masonry. Oh, we can get whales there. Okay. So, can we take the city this turn? Yes, great, love it, beautiful. Reyna goes in. I know, Reyna, you were just back and forth and back and forth and back and forth, but, you're doing good work, trust me. Okay. I forgot to swap out my policies. I am a fool. Now I can start building a granary. Old Faithful, what's that do? It yields 3 science, 1 faith, and 1 gold, and campus districts trigger a culture bomb in any city. Double adjacency bonuses for campus districts if their city has a national park. That's a pretty cool wonder. That has some very specific use cases for certain civs that would just skyrocket their yields. I'm thinking of in particular. We want a water mill. Am I just getting to the point where I'm buying things to spend the money? I very well might be. And you know what? That's fine. Let's start building a water mill. I'm thinking of Australia. Australia would synergize so well with Old Faithful. I guess we should just get mathematics. Where do we want to sort of move to? Maybe education. I don't think that's a bad idea. And then Katna industrial zone buildings maybe purchase the faith and provide +1 production. That's a cool city state. Well, we'll put an envoy in there to take advantage of our current policy card. And we could just throw another one in there right now and grab suzerainty. I like that. Let's do that. That'll give us a lot of exploration. Give us an idea of where we want to send future settlers. So, Basil is over here. Let's declare friendship with him. And then if we want to get settlers on this continent, we're going to need to move quick before Basil has a chance to fill in this terrain. discarding of it for production. Doesn't have much production in this city. I could buy out to this reef, which is gives them a nice dial to work. I might do that. Took out this barbarian camp here.
May the forces of evil.
Okay. So this builder, I think their fate is mine, corporation, or industry. And then fishing boat. Okay, everybody here, just fortify the old process of just kind of hanging out, capturing the city over and over again is continuing the noble tradition of our forefathers. I would love the age to switch so that I'm in my golden age and can actually hold Calamane. The other option is capturing Eindhoven. It doesn't have walls, so that is, you know, not a bad option. They're building the Great Lighthouse. I would like to have the Great Lighthouse. For no other reason than it is a coastal wonder, and so it contributes to my civability. Okay. This gives 25% gold in the city, which is, you know, it's not bad. I kind of would prefer that in Calamane, because Calamane's going to be making a lot of gold. So I'm almost wondering if I do want to put the corporation here, and then Mombasa just won't have a corporation. Yeah, I do want the synergy of the gold there, because Calamane will be a very heavy gold city if everything goes well. Also, Eindhoven is stealing my tiles, and I'm not happy about it. But not much to be done when I'm fighting for my life over here with loyalty pressure. Hercules is around for 9 turns, so he'll be able to help us take the city back one more time, and that's that. But the arrow's flipping in 6 turns, so it's okay. I think that will be enough. And you go improve that cattle. You can attack this galley. Making some iron. Oh boy. Man, it's tough wanting to. I want to get Petra, but I just can't do anything in the city until the loyalty is under control, although that'll be in like 5 turns, so I guess I should start researching Petra now, so that it'll be ready to go. If I want to have a chance, I just gotta move quick with it. So, yeah, tell you what, oh no, Petra's in tech. We'll go to mathematics right now. If we could get another district down, that'd be great, but, used mathematics for us and get us Petra a little quicker. Granted, we were one turn away from oh, you know what I should do? I should buy out of this reef on my next turn. That's a lot of gold. I'll take that deal. Always happy to get more gold. We're going to be a gold and culture focused civ. Well, not culture exactly necessarily, but tourism. We'll win a culture victory. Or, you know, maybe another kind. I'm not closing us off to anything else. But, let's go heal you. Yeah, Pastor is fine. You go build me an industry. And then we're buying some tiles for you. That's two good tiles for our city there. And then we could go feudalism for extra bill charges with the serfdom policy card. Or civil service for alliances. I think in terms of government, we're probably gonna go merchant republic. But we could consider a different one. I mean, there's so many wonders that unlock. I mean, three. It's not so many, but you know, three wonders unlock from Divine Right and Reformed Church. But I think we're gonna go exploration for the extra gold and production. And then Pingala needs to get us a bit more. I think we want to get a bit more culture. Our culture is hurting. So plus 7 culture will be a big help. Left. And then this builder can go get us a fishing boat there. And do we want to go feudalism? Yeah. I don't think we need alliances yet. Because I don't want to. I mean, I guess I would be pretty comfortable making an alliance with Basil. So maybe we, do stop off at civil service, actually, so we grab civil service, and then exploration. Sip of my water. Okay. Now, who do we want to promote? I think Pingala, we're going to put Grants gives us double great people points earned in the city, and that synergizes pretty well with the Oracle. Now, the only issue is that I just built a government plaza, which doesn't give us any great people points, so that was a little silly on my part. Instead of building a place that would capitalize on those abilities, but that's fine. We all make mistakes from time to time. And I just happen to make a lot of them rebels next turn, we will take it back, and then our loyalty in a golden age should be good enough, unless Wilhelmina and the Netherlands are going to make me unhappy and end up with a very high loyalty pressure on us. These cities still don't have walls. It really makes me wish I had started building an army a while ago and had something to go to war with. We're gonna get construction because that'll let us get a bit more production out of like this forest. I guess that's actually like the only forest. That's fine. Okay, hit the city. Can you take the city? Yes, you can. So, I'll give you guys a little bit of experience. And then, I mean, these are all levy units, so I'm gonna lose them in a bit, but ideally they'll still be on my side, right? So, good to give them a bit of experience. Kill a main. Reyna pops back in there. Build a granary and then a lighthouse. And let's see. You need to go up there and give me an industry. Let's see what the loyalty looks like after this. Okay, Poland's at war with Wilhelmina, which is interesting. Yes, I'll take this deal. A bit of gold is fine. I also noticed that my coffee deal expired, so I'll go to the quick deals. And quick deals is a mod, by the way, that really makes Oh, by the way, this is pretty cool. So we were in a dark age, and we got enough era score to get into a golden age, and so now we are in a heroic age. Which means we get to choose three of these. And we're not in a religion game, so we don't care about Exodus of the Evangelists. So it's just kind of obvious. We're going to go Free Inquiry, Pen, Brush, and Voice, and Monumentality. And basically what that does is it makes our Eurekas and our Inspirations a bit more effective. Commercial hubs and harbors are going to give us science. And which is good because we have three pretty good harbors. And then all of our districts give us one culture. And then also we can purchase civilian units with faith, and they are cheaper to purchase. You all heal up. You can promote. You heal. You heal. And our Hercules. And look at this. Full loyalty in six turns, so our loyalty problems are no more. We got a great scientist here that will trigger two random Eureka moments and one random inspiration moment from the medieval Renaissance era. I don't love these great scientists that just give you little boosts like that. It's a little boring in my opinion, but it's fine. Also, we can. It's a very small bonus, but we can appreciate that because we're going to activate this guy right next to pillar tomb in Kilwakisuwani. It means that that pillar tomb will now provide us plus one gold each turn. So, a very small boost, but I'm actually going to wait a turn because our water mill is about to complete, which will boost construction, and that would just be a shame if one of the boosts that Omar Khayyam gave us was construction. It'd be sort of a waste. So Hercules is about to die, so we'll just let him expire peacefully in his sleep. Also, all of our builders move faster now that we have monumentality. Oops, I forgot to go to quick deals and sell off our coffee. for herself, but it's not crazy important, I guess. Great scientists. I'm not actually going to spend any money on that. Not money, a diplomatic favor. No points earned towards great scientists. And we did win the culture bomb one, so that's a bit annoying that no scientists are going to be getting earned. Boring, I say. Okay, we got divine right, banking, and gunpowder boosted. We'll go for... If we want to carry on a war, let's get buttresses so that we can take out Eindhoven with our naval melee units pretty easily. Industry goes there. These warriors just get out of here. Okay, let's sell our coffee. So, and she's gonna give us more money. Wilhelmina is, but we're probably gonna go to war with her soon. So I'll take the lower gold deal. We also have a bunch of money that, you know, seems a shame not to spend, so. Where to spend it, though? Where to spend it? We're gonna buy this granary outright. This is supposed to be our commercial hub, and we definitely do want that there. So it's fine. Let's just start building Petra right now, because we want to get that built, and we're going to emphasize food and production in the city just to make sure that they're not doing any of these unproductive tiles. And then finally, actually, no, we're done. We're done for the start. This builder will build us a fishing boat. We should consider settling some more cities, getting a few more cities up and running. If we could take Suzerainty, if that city state, that'd be nice. But I don't think it's likely. I think, okay, our Achilles is gone. And, much beloved he was. Alright, this boat can just auto-explore. I don't want to deal with it. And then, let's put a pasture on that. So, Monaco will give us 50 gold, and it will satisfy a city-state quest, so I like that. Yo, 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 that's pretty good. Arthur, we just found Arthur. Arthur is a great hero for going to war, so I think if we get Arthur and somebody doesn't snag him from us, we're going to go to war with the Netherlands then. Going here. These levied warriors, I don't much care what they do. They can just hang out, chill. Tell me this, how much is it to recruit Hercules? Almost 1,000 faith. Wowie. So it'll be quite a while before we get there. the city, we'll try to build the Colossus and see if we're able to do that. And if not, we'll go ahead and get the Warlord's Throne, since we might be doing a bit of warring, and then a lighthouse. So, Mombasa is having some trouble with the production. I'd like to help, but I guess, okay, here's what we can do to help. We will buy out to here, and then we will buy a builder, and that builder will put a lumber mill on that forest. I guess I'll put a pasture here. I have a suspicion that that tile is going to be replaced with a district eventually, but that's fine. We'll put the pasture there anyways and take the loss of the builder charge if we decide. Whoops. I forgot that we only had one trade route, and it's not going to Wilhelmina now, and so she is TO'd at us. That's fine. That's totally okay. Okay, we have strong boats now. Let's see if we can make an alliance with... Yes, we can. We're going to go for a military alliance. You want a lot of money, but that's fine. I mean, 4 gold per turn is not a lot of money, but frankly, any amount of money to me feels like a lot. We're going to grab cartography. You go there, build me a lumber mill. And then... So I think the move here will be that I don't love Eindhoven's location, but I'll probably capture it anyways and not raise it. Because, you know, cities are cities. Okay, they have a pikeman, which is rough, because that's a fairly advanced unit. They've built this weird little city here. Yeesh, okay. I guess we'll just go improve the camels down there. Oh, you know, we should definitely buy that reef for more production for the city. See if there's any people that wanna make some deals with us. You know, pick up any extra money that we can. Okay, I don't wanna sell stuff to Wilhelmina, so we will ignore that. Keep it moving. Ah, Poundmaker. I love Poundmaker. Let's see if he'll take a delegation. And he did. Now let's get open borders with him. Favorably to us, because if we get an alliance with him, then, oh good, he sent us a threatening message, but his icon shows that he's friendly, and if we get an alliance with him, Poundmaker has a trait where he has shared visibility with all, everybody that he's in an alliance with, so we will get a huge boost to our map visibility if we make an alliance. Declare friendship. friendship. He said, yes, I love that. And now we'll go ahead and take an economic alliance. We're probably not going to be able to trade with him anytime soon. So the particular alliance doesn't matter. Okay, the Vredefort Dome. Mount Roraima. And we met Siam. And we met Jumpy. Come witness the beauty of Uluru. Just don't try to climb it, alright? Alright, we had made a lot of discoveries there. So we'll try to send a delegation to these two new folks, in addition to making open borders with them, because these are all just ways to increase our relationship with them, have them view us more positively, and increase the chances that they will make an alliance with us. And alliances are good in general, unless you're specifically planning on, you know, going to war or something like that. But alliances are generally good because you get to... I maybe should have kept that iron on second thought. But that's totally fine. Totally, totally fine. This is an interesting map. It is just lots and lots of water. This is a really crappy continent that two civilizations spawned on. Yikes. What was that one wonder? I don't think I've ever seen it before. There was Mount Roraima, and then there was another one. And... can't seem to... oh, here it is. The Vredefort Dome. Two food, two science, and one culture, and farms provide +1 food when adjacent to another farm. For any civilization that owns at least one of these tiles. Okay, that's pretty good. Alright. We also met a bunch more city-states. Amsterdam is, the Galapagos Islands, I don't think I even noticed that those were there. Okay, this is a crime. The Netherlands did not settle a city close enough to claim a tile of the Galapagos Islands. That's really, really, criminal. Okay. We have a builder charge here. Oh, let's go send it down there to get us a fishing boat. Now, so this might be able to be mostly a naval war if we get a navy quick and then just start blasting these cities. We are getting Arthur, so is the cog better than the caravel? Probably not. The cog is a medieval melee unit, so the caravel is better. So we'll upgrade, we'll wait for cartography to finish, and then upgrade this to a caravel. Melindy is going to finish Arthur in 6 turns. So, between our caravel and Arthur, we should have a pretty good this, I built a city right on this little peninsula, which I don't really want to do. A new barbarian outpost has moved into a region that I don't really care about. Yeah, I'm definitely falling. I really should be pumping out settlers. And I'm not. And now, Byzantium is doing it. It's gonna be taking some of this ripe land here that I really should have gotten into before they had a chance. I wonder what I can buy from this. I'm gonna buy a man at arms because, well, not only because they're a very strong unit, but because heroes scale off of your strongest unit. So Arthur is gonna get a really big boost to his stats because of that man at arms. Katarokama. Yeah, we don't have their visibility anymore, so the Netherlands better not have taken them. Okay, no, we just naturally lost them, so we'll need to put an envoy back in there if we want him back. Jedwicka has made peace with the Netherlands. This is a really strange map. Starting to get some of this mini-map revealed, and it's weird. Really hardly seem like continents to me. They've got very bad land on them anyways. Yeah, I'll take a delegation. Alright, we discovered cartography. Let's check our cards here. We have a barbarian one that isn't really yielding us anything. Oh, veterancy for extra production towards harbors and their buildings. That's a good card that I should have had in campus adjacency. I do like to keep Diplomatic League, you know, I'm getting a lot of city-states, but, well, actually, I will keep Diplomatic League in, because in case we accidentally, you know, fulfill any quests or whatever, it's just really good value to get an extra envoy. Oh, crap. Should we go for apprenticeship? Yeah, we're gonna start making our way to apprenticeship. We got a great admiral who helps medieval and renaissance units. So our caravel that we just got is going to be even stronger. And then we can get Katarokama back. Which is good, because that helps our faith income, and also gives us the chance to levy them. And Arthur is about to take the field. Sea ghosts. Okay. few melee units there backing it up, the city should fall pretty easily. How much will it be to levy Katarokama? 320 gold, so we will need to, let's see if anybody will give us a bit of gold for our iron. Yes, we'll sell it to Siam. And then what about our diplomatic favor? What if we just hawk it all? I bet we could get some good money at this point. 17 gold per turn plus 33 immediately. I'll take that deal. So here's the move. We're going to levy Katarokama and then convert their warriors into questing knights and use their men-at-arms just to, you know, as a man-at-arms, because that's good enough as it is. But I should make... Oh. Samarkand just joined the land. Your civilization gains 2% science for each great person it's ever earned. Now that's a great city-state. That's a great, great city-state. You're gonna build me a lighthouse. And then the mausoleum, perhaps. Or should Malindi be building me the mausoleum? Hard to say. Yeah, we do want the mausoleum, so we gotta, you know, prioritize it. And then, I don't know. We gotta get another, I would love to get the Colosseum. Because, you know, it's a good idea to plant your districts down quickly, because they get a discount. Their price is locked in, and they only get more expensive as time goes on, so it's good to get them down quick. Their men-at-arms. It's right there. It's not in the city yet. Okay. Turn that scout into a questing knight. Oh, whoops. I declared the war. Yeah, that was silly. So he got booted out, basically. And yeah, very smart of me. Brain moves. Okay, well, we're gonna levy Katarokama's military. And then, we will hold off on this attack. Or, well, we'll destroy that guy that's embarked. We'll get education for a bit more science. We can start putting universities in our cities. Arthur needs somebody to upgrade, and I don't have anybody nearby except for these warriors. What I should probably do is buy another scout in Kelemane. Okay. Yeah, so they ended up garrisoning the man at arms in Eindhoven, which, you know, of course, it's their strongest unit, so. But that is the sad part of not having been able to kill him immediately. Because now it's going to make the city a bit more difficult to take. This warrior will just try to get on dry land, I guess. Same with this one. This warrior can explore. You're never even going to reach... okay, yes, so here's what we will do. Buy a scout, march Arthur down, turn the scout into a Questing Knight, send the Questing Knight up there. This Questing Knight kills the archer. Arthur runs a little closer to the front lines. You skip your turn. This warrior can go approach the shores as well. Sure. Maybe the world will soon be rid of your treachery. Okay. I have great respect for those who declare their friendships to the world. Thank you. Thank you, Poundmaker. Thank you for not holding this, war, unprovoked war against me. Okay, so Sun Wukong has arrived, which, you know, I mean, it's not exactly good to have the enemy hero on the field, but frankly, if I had to pick a hero for it to be, Sun Wukong is one of the, you know, the more preferable ones. Oh, and we got the Colossus. At Rhodes was set up a Colossus of 70 cubits high, representing the sun. The artist expended as much bronze on it as seemed likely to create a dearth in the mines. Philo of Byzantium. Which does give us a traitor. And we'll send the traitor up to trade with Poundmaker. The Sardine, our reliable boat, the Sardine. You will pillage for a bit of health. And then, What to do? You get there. Arthur, go back and convert into a Questing Knight. This Questing Knight, this step. Questing Knight fills the gap. You can heal for a turn, if possible. This man at arms can just hang around. And then Arthur begins to walk back. This Questing Knight hits you on the head. And still, we'll skip. We don't want to start beating ourselves on the city until we really need to. Grab stirrups to get knights unlocked. Okay, so we still have a diplomatic league in, and we have 3 envoys to use. So, I think envoy 1 goes to Samarkand. Envoy 2 goes to Balai. And then, Mrs. Ema. Yeah, apologize for inflicting my stump. Okay, why do the Dutch have these people, like, coming up from the northeast? Why were they sending their troops to the weirdest locations around the world? Alright, well, that's fine. We'll get enough money in, like, a turn to buy a strong unit and deal with them. But they might do a bit of pillaging, which is, you know, unfortunate, but certainly not the end of the world. Okay, so that man-at-arms got, that questing knight got hit pretty hard. And that's okay. For healing purposes, and then Arthur can finish off Sun Wukong, and I don't think that's a bad idea, so we'll do that. And then this guy just steps forward. You can swap places and pillage for health while you fortify. Still, we're not going to attack the city because we're not quite ready to start hitting these people yet. In a turn, we'll get knights. Although we won't quite have the iron to build one, will we? So that's rough. Yeah. These guys are going to be annoying, aren't they? Makes me happy that you leave the Wonder Building to us. Well, maybe not the best thing to hear from, not the best thing to hear. Oh, the Dutch plundered our trade route. That is unfortunate. I was going to say not the best thing to hear when we are a civ that wants to build a lot of wonders. I want to buy another scout so that he can run up to Arthur and give us another questing knight, because I got a fever.